Evening, everyone. My name is Duke. Welcome to an Apple stream. Not a modern Apple stream. There won't be any iPod or iPhone or anything else beginning with I in the stream. We're talking about the Apple II, specifically the Apple IIe, which is probably best known, at least in the US, as the computer anyone who was born between 1980 and, I don't know, 1990-ish used in school. I know we certainly had these until I was in, I want to say up until 10th grade, my first official year of high school. Because we had junior high in high school instead of middle school. So pretty sure we used, or we at least had Apple IIe's in the classroom up until my last year of junior high, 9th grade. But I also had one at home. I had an Apple IIc, which is basically like the PlayStation Slim of its day. It's like the smaller, more, I don't know, quote-unquote portable version of the Apple IIe. You still had to power it, you know, it didn't use batteries or anything, but it had a handle, which I guess that's what you call a portable computer back in those days. So to start things off, I'm going to play one of the two games you probably played if you used an Apple IIe in school. Obviously, Oregon Trail is the big one. That's the famous one. And I won't be playing Oregon Trail in this stream simply because a game of that takes a pretty long time, and I want to devote, you know, enough time to do a full run of that. Because I did Oregon Trail, the modern zombie take on Oregon Trail, and I thought that was pretty fun because you can name your party members after, you know, friends or people in the chat room or whatever. And I'd like to do the same with the original. But to start things off, we are going to play a little game called Number Munchers. Also by Mech, the same company that produced the original Oregon Trail. Yes, I will be playing with a joystick. Not really sure why this option is here, because I wouldn't expect any school setting to have a joystick with a computer, which is primarily where this game would be played. But since the emulator I'm using, AppleWind, does have USB joystick support, I'm going to go ahead and choose yes. And interestingly, you can move through the menu with the joystick, but you can't actually select an option. You have to use a keyboard for that, which is kind of weird. So this is a brand new copy of the game. So there won't be any high score list or anything. Any interesting information we can glean about the game? Okay. So I was really bad at this game, and I probably still will be. Oh hey, what's up, Sarah the Lich? I probably will still be bad at this game simply because mental math was never my strong suit. There is another Munchers game called Word Munchers, and I shall also be taking a look at that. And that game should be trivially easy. Sarah, let me know if everything looks good on the stream. I'm crossing my fingers that Twitch is going to work this time, but if not, then I will make the switch over to Hitbox. Do not use game paddles or a graphics tablet. I will not use a graphics tablet to play this game. Thanks for the advice. Let's see. Back out of the game, turn the sound on or off. Oh, hey. If your colors at home look odd, you can use the screen to adjust them. And everyone watching, make sure you call this number so you can order a copy of the Number Munchers manual. I'm sure that'll come in handy. So there's the phone number. I should call that number and just see what happens. Or write to them, you know. Either one. Alright, so let's go ahead and get started. This game is Let the computer decide. I'm going to start with multiple since that's probably the easiest one. St. Paul, Minnesota. Maybe they know the MST3K guys. Yeah, possibly. I mean, they were active at roughly the same time, I think. I'm not sure. Well, MEC was around in like the early to mid-90s because they made further Oregon Trail games, at least. So I know they were still around at that point. Hell, they might still be around for all I know. It's not like I pay attention to educational software. Yes, I would like instructions. Please, instruct me. And hopefully that wasn't ear-piercingly loud for you guys. I have the sound turned down really low, but the simulator outputs sound at like an extremely high volume, like higher than normal. So if you need me to turn it down a bit, let me know. So this is our hero, Munchicus Digitus, taking a cue from the old Roadrunner cartoons with the scientific, the made-up scientific nomenclature. And these are the enemies in the game. I believe they do have different patterns, kind of like the ghosts in Pac-Man. They have different, quote-unquote, personalities. Hey, what's up, Lord Tamar? Lord Tamar. So let's see, press question mark key to pause, or timeout as they refer to it. Oh, you lose some points each time you call timeout. Weird. What game makes you lose points for pausing? Safe zones. If a box has little boxes in the corner, then you can stay there and the enemies can't go there. And keyboard controls don't apply to me. Right. Watch the computer play. That's okay. I think I have it under control. Alright, so we're going to start off with multiples of two here, which is obviously the easiest one. Simply any even number. And this game does get surprisingly hard, considering I was playing this in like third or fourth grade. If you get far enough, the numbers do get extremely large. Multiples of three, okay, also pretty easy. Let's see, 28, nope, 21, however, yes, 15 is a multiple of three. 21, okay. Oh, see, I told you. See, I was thinking of, never mind. So I lost a life for that one. You can see my lives down there in the bottom right-hand corner. And you will get more lives if you get a certain number of points. Let's see, 27, yeah, okay. And this is the basic Troggle, who just kind of goes in a straight path, doesn't really punch you down or anything. Oh yeah, 12, because 4 times 3 is 12. And 32, I know no better than, oh, right, 8 times 3 is 24. Let's see. What am I missing? No, I know 25 isn't. 28, no. Oh, 18, obviously. 6 times 3. Alright. Multiples of 4, okay. Getting a little trickier here. 16, 7 times 4 is 28. Let's see. Yep. Yep, 36, I know that. Yep. No. Oh yeah, because obviously, because 2 times 16 is 32, okay. So, okay, so here's the thing about playing games on the Apple II. The response time is very variable depending on how much stuff is going on the screen. Slowdown is just a constant issue with the Apple II. Twitch working without a hitch, that's awesome. Glad to hear it. So occasionally you run into issues where you think you push a direction, but you don't actually push that direction. Which caused me to be eaten by that Troggle there. But I mean, I'm not going to spend too much time on this game. I just want to get to the first cutscene. And then I will switch to Word Munchers. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Awesome. Here we go. Great Moments in Muncher History, Act 1. So I always thought the number muncher looked kind of like a frog. Oh, here's another easy one. Multiples of 5. Just anything ending with a 5 or a 0. Yeah, he looks kind of like just a stylized frog. I don't know. I don't think he's supposed to be any specific animal, but, I know 54 is not a multiple of 5. I didn't mean to go 2 squares. I meant to go 1 square. Thanks, game. And any issues you see with slowdown is not the emulator, because, like I said, I actually play these games on the Apple II, and, the machine experiences these problems. Alright, multiples of 6. Alright, getting into the higher numbers now. 6? This is... Yeah, 6 times 7, I think, is 42. Let's see, 36? Yep. 54? No, I don't think so. 36, there we go. Oh, 30. Yeah, that's a thing. Let's see. 48, yes. Sometimes you have to just wait for the toggles to leave the screen before it'll... maybe 54 is multiple 6. Oh, yeah, I guess it is. Weird. Alright, well, there's another 54 down here. So, toggle! Oh, here's the uglier version of the toggles. Let's see. Oh, here's another 54. Oh, yeah, they can eat each other. That's awesome. I forgot about that. Let's see. Oh, 60, obviously. Yay! Maybe I can make it to the next cutscene. I am out of lives, so. Alright. 28, yes. 20, no. No. 35 is a multiple of 7. See, when those two things come on the screen, they just totally make the system, or when they move even, they just make everything slow down by a factor of 10. I'm not 100% sure it was this bad on the original hardware. I do know it was pretty bad though. 49? Yeah. Okay. Another 49. Let's see. 35? Okay. 63? That sounds right. Yeah. Oh, and another 7. Let's see. Oh, 42, right? Yeah, 6 times 7, 42. Of course, if you read The Hitchhiker's Guide, then you would think it was 6 times 9 is 42. Is 56 1? Yeah, because 49 is 1. And 40, yeah, okay. Excellent. Oh, okay, here we go. Act 2. Alright, he's on the run. We're chasing him. Uh-oh, it's a troggle. What are you going to do, Number Muncher? Oh, he invented the car. Well, they say necessity is the mother of invention, so... Ah! He got that darn troggle. Oh, hey, what's up, Galen? Okay, so... that's about enough for now. Enough of Number Munchers. they're shouting out solutions in the chat room. Unfortunately, I wasn't really able to look at the chat while I was playing. But I appreciate it nonetheless. Alright, let's switch over and have a look at Word Munchers now. Word Munchers is a lot simpler than I thought it was. Unfortunately, I thought there was going to be some... hit reset here. I thought there was going to be some, like, identify the adjective or identify the adverb or, you know, something that takes a little bit of brain power. Yes. But all Word Munchers is, there's only one mode, unlike Number Munchers. Pretty sure the instructions are exactly the same. Let's take a look at them anyway. Oh, his scientific name has changed. It is Munchicus Scripticus now. instead of Munchicus digitus. So it's a different species that only feeds on words. Alright. Same troggles. Same timeout, safe zones, yep, joystick, keyboard. Oh, it didn't have the phone number and address this time. Alright, so all numbered munchers is, or all word munchers is identifying the rhyming words. So, or not rhymes, but identifying the vowels. So I have to eat every word that has a vowel sound that, of A as in hat. So, mad, that's one. Snag, yep. Tap. Lad, tap. Oh, see, he couldn't go in a straight line because there was a safe zone here. So he had to turn. I think it's a 90 degree counterclockwise turn every time, which is with this struggle. So mask. Let's see. Yep. So in this game, it's not so much the educational aspect of it that's difficult. It's just eventually there's a billion troggles running around on the screen, and you have to struggle with them and fight with controls. What am I? Oh. See, when a troggle goes over a word, it'll change it. So you have to be on the lookout. Am I missing something? Let's see. Maybe I just have to wait for the troggle to leave. Oh, here we go. Wait. Oh. Duh. Hey, what's up, Just Drop? Alright. As in duck. Oops. Alright. Yep, fuzz. Stub. Oh, see, it's tricky because it's a different letter with the same vowel sound. The sound of a safe zone coming in is pretty much identical to the sound my chat client makes when someone says Duke. So every time one of these pops up, I think someone's addressing me. Yep. Okay. I as in kite. Okay. So yeah, it's not the most fascinating game in the world, but you know, when you're 9 years old and in school, you know, getting to play any game in school is pretty cool. Let's see. Oh. Alright. Different cutscenes in this one. Owned. By the way, the sound hardware in the Apple II is absolutely horrible, so most games don't actually have like background music the way the Commodore 64 and other more powerful PCs at the time did, but you wouldn't want them to have background music anyway. Alright, what am I doing here? Let's see. As you can see, I am doing much better in this game than I was in Number Munchers. Let's at least get to the next cutscene in this one as well. I like how it has a little drawing up in the top right hand corner to remind you what you're looking for. Uh-oh, two troggles. Better watch out. Oh, he ate that pea. Dang it. See, the controls are just unbelievably sluggish when there are two on the screen at once. when they're standing still, you're okay, but if they move, then what? Oh, he didn't need to pee. He just walked over. Weird. Maybe sometimes they don't change it. I am super good at vowels, guys. Moon, okay. I can do that. Let's see. See, they're trying to... Oh, hey, it's me. I do. They're trying to trick me by having double O's that don't make the O sound. I'm too smart for that, though. I won't fall for that. Let's see. What am I missing? No, these all... Oh, see, sometimes you just have to wait for them to move. Alright, Act 2. Here we go. We are... Okay. Not sure why they're in space. Are these characters supposed to be aliens or something? I don't know. Alright, so that is Word Munchers. Yeah, like I said, they're pretty dumb as far as games go, but getting to play any video game in school, it was always a treat. And since I had an Apple II at the time, I could sometimes bring my own games to the school, which is an especially special treat. Alright, let's go for one more educational game before I move on to some of the weirder stuff. This is another game I remember playing a lot in school. I didn't own any of the Munchers games or this game. This is Odell Lake. Is my volume like really high? It sounds like I'm clipping. Maybe I'm just getting too close to the mic. This is a game where you play some sort of aquatic creature. Oh, right, the joystick doesn't work at all with this one. That's right. Specifically a lake creature. Now let's see what it says. How to play. Oh, it's a simulation game. It's Lake Creature Simulator 1984, in which you take the role of a fish in Odell Lake, Oregon. I don't think you're always a fish. I think there are other things you can be, or maybe you just encounter other things. You meet various forms of animal and plant life, including other types of fish. Oh, maybe you do have to be a fish. Each time you meet another animal or a plant, you must decide what to do. Your decisions determine whether or not you survive. So this is pretty high stakes for elementary school. Go exploring or play for points. Oh, so you can go exploring like a bunch of casuals, or you know, you can play for real. Choose the type of fish you want to play. You're told the names of the plants and animals you meet. You can take as much time as you want to decide what to do. Oh, so it really is casual mode. And then playing for points is hardcore mode. You're shown pictures of the plants and animals you meet, but not names. You have a limited amount of time to make each decision. Sounds seems good. Okay, cool. And same special keys. Escape to quit, Control S to turn sound off. Oh, teacher information. Here we go. Yeah, like, we never did any, like, assignments around this game or anything. It was just one of the discs that we could put in, like, when there's nothing really to do and we were just kind of dicking around. We never, like, wrote an essay about Odell Lake or anything. Oh, there we go. Contact the mech company if you would like information on other mech products. I certainly would. Oh, and you can adjust your screen. Okay, that's enough. So let's go exploring once, and then I will play for points once. Survive 11 encounters with other creatures. Okay, so the idea is to do this mode until you learn how the creatures interact with each other, and then once you have it down, you can play for points, and you know, it's more exciting or something, I guess. Okay, yeah, these are all fish. For some reason, I was thinking a chub isn't a fish, but I guess it is. Well, let's be a Mackinac trout, since that's a cool-sounding word. Also, note the reddish, or I guess that's a magenta-ish tint, and the green tint around some of the letters. That's a feature of the Apple II. That's not a bug. Well, it's not a bug with the emulator. This is how it actually looked on the monitor. It's a little more noticeable when you're playing on like a crisp LCD screen than on a CRT. Like on a CRT, everything kind of like blurred together. On this, it's a lot more noticeable. Yeah. So Mackinac trout. I look like this. I see a whitefish ahead. Okay. So my usual strategy in this game is to eat pretty much everything, unless I know for a fact it's something that can kill me. So let's eat the whitefish. No sound effects in this one. Oh, there we go. That's a good eating sound effect. That was certainly a big meal. Awesome. An osprey. Okay. If you've never played this game before, then you may not know what that is. But I know that that's a bird. So I'm just gonna chill. You know, I'm a deep water fish, and osprey can't get down here. So I'm just going to ignore. That's the ignoring sound effect. Damn straight it won't get me. A chub? Yeah. That can't kill me. Uh-oh. I forgot that could happen. So wait, are chub always bait? Should I just ignore those all the time, or... Huh. Yeah, let's do one more. Let's be a Dolly Varden this time. Is that real? That sounds like a made-up name. Is it named after, like, Dolly Parton? Okay, so this time I actually have to run away. So, deep escape from the osprey. Whitefish? Okay. So if it gives me another chub, I'm probably going to try to eat it just to see if I get caught again. Excellent. A group of bottom organisms? Well, it can't kill me, so... Looks like we got a crayfish, a snail, and a worm. One of my favorite foods. Awesome. A group of animal plankton. Okay. Man, check out the rendering on that plankton. There are foods that I like a lot better. Well, you know, this is about survival. This isn't about what I like and don't like. Rainbow trout. I don't think that can kill me. It's pretty big. But I seem to be a touch bigger. Awesome. Yeah, there's no, like, hunger mechanic or anything like that. You just, Alright, let's eat the chub and see if I get caught again. That might have just been a random thing. Okay. Oh. Excellent. An otter? Why I otter? I don't think that'll do anything to me. I don't know. It might be able to kill me. Maybe I should escape. Let's go deep escape. Not sure what the difference between... Oh, man, that thing's big. What the difference between deep and shallow escape is. It won't come after you when you are so deep. Huh? Okay. I guess otters don't like deep water. Group of insects and insect larvae. Okay. I'll eat that. They look like sprites from the Game of Life. Blueback salmon. Go for it. Mackinac Trout. Why not? Oh, that thing might actually be able to eat me. It looks a little bigger. Oh no. You now reside in the stomach of a large predator. Wah, wah, wah. I remember that. Thank you, Odolik. That is a hard-learned lesson. Alright. Let's do it for real this time. After every 5 moves, you play a different fish. Oh, wow. Oh, I see. So when it says, like, there are foods you like better, I guess you have more points if you ignore those, because it says the best decisions earn you the most points. A rainbow trout. Okay, that's a pretty small fish. Pretty sure I can eat whatever that thing is, though. Oh, you're on a timer, too. Wow. I wonder if you get more points for reacting more quickly. Eating fish even as small as a chub isn't really... Oh, eating fish even as small as a chub isn't really your style. Okay, so apparently rainbow trouts only eat, like, the lake crud. Let's escape, I guess. I think you'll probably eat me. It's harmless to me. Oh, so I got minus 3 points for that, because apparently that's not as good a decision as ignoring it. I don't know. Luckily, I still have 0 points. Uh-oh. It was like, yeah, that was an osprey noise. I recognize that. Plus 20 points. Yes! Okay. That thing's probably harmless. I'm just going to ignore it. I should have chased it. Oh. Well, dang it. I didn't know that game. Oh, hey. I can eat that crap. It's like seaweed or something. Oh, a massive algae. Okay, apparently I won't eat algae. Didn't realize rainbow trouts were so picky. That thing could probably eat me. Oh, wait, no. Those don't eat fish, right? I'm going to ignore it. I'm too small to chase that fish away. It's hard out there. Oh, crap. Deep escape. Yeah. Not easy being a chub. That thing looks like it could eat me. Bye. Excellent. It's a lot more generous with the positive points than with the negative. I don't think that'll eat me, will it? It said those don't eat fish, right? Yeah, leave them alone. Run. Oh, okay, well... I wanted to go that way anyway. I mean, now I'm a blueback salmon, but that's an osprey, so I still need to run. I was going to say I want to mess some stuff up. Oh, that's the same thing. I want to chase that away so it won't eat my food. Oh. Oh, apparently it wasn't the same thing. It had a blue back. How was I supposed to know? Oh, hey, I made it to the Odell Lake High Score list. Look how awesome I am. 94 points. No, that's enough of that for now. Alright, let's see. So I set aside some of the games I played the most when I had the Apple IIc. I'm not sure if I'll get to all of them tonight. I want to show off at least a few of them. Let's see. So this is an interesting game. This is the license game based on Conan the Barbarian. and enjoy this title sequence because it takes up an entire side of the disc. Oh shit. Check out that effect. Hell yeah. This is my jam. Yep, so that whole thing was one side of a disc, so let me swap to side two. And press a key. Boy, check out that font. Alright, so you can use the joystick for this one. Now, the interesting thing about this game is that I don't think it was originally supposed to be a Conan game. Because A, this character doesn't look anything like Conan. If anything, it looks more like a woman. I mean, I don't want to say a character is a woman just because it has long hair and looks like it might have breasts, but I mean, it's hard to tell with such a small mass of pixels, but so yeah, this is your character, and you run around throwing axes. So, I'm not sure if Conan was known for his axe-throwing skills, but, yeah, I think this is just some random game that they just slapped the Conan license on. But, much like the copy of this game that I had when I was a kid, this is a cracked copy of the game. And, there are cheats built into this copy, so... Oh. As you can see, I was just killed by that bat thing, but I didn't lose any men. You can tell it's a game from the 1980s because they call extra lives men. So I just need to wait for that thing to fly down here and then hit it with an axe. Now, in addition to having an infinite number of lives, every time I throw an axe, you can see my axe counter keeps going up because... Now, this actually didn't happen on my copy of the game. On my copy, when you threw an axe, the number went down by one, and when it returned to you, it goes back up. And obviously, sometimes it doesn't return to you, and you would just lose that axe. But in this copy, you have all the axes you need. And you can crash the game with that, which I'm going to do in a few minutes here. No fall damage. Whee! Man, after that amazing intro music, it's seems kind of quiet and lonely in this castle. Alright, grab that key. Turn into an amorphous blob of purple as I climb up this ladder. And there's no air control, so if you're standing still when you jump, you can't control your movement, so you kind of have to move and jump. It's a little finicky. Alright, this level's annoying because you can't kill any of these enemies. They're all too low to the ground for you to hit with your axe, so you just have to avoid them. We have a scorpion, and we have a couple ants. So what I have to do is I have to wait for that teleporter, teleport up and get that green thing, which I always called a mushroom. I have no idea what it's actually oops, I didn't make it to the teleporter in time. Yeah, for some reason I always thought that thing looks like a mushroom. I don't know. Aw man, now the ant made it up there. Bummer. Sigh. Screw the mushroom. Let's just jump. I'm sure we can make it, right? Nope. Alright, both the ants are down here. Alright, got it. Now, I'm pretty sure I can just die. Now, keep the mushroom. Yeah, that's the easiest way to do it. Alright, let's see what happens when I put this mushroom in this rook. Now, here's your pro Conan the Barbarian strategy. You want to ride this bubble as high as you can, because the more you ride it, the more points you get. And then, at the last minute, jump down to the next level. Now, for some reason, everything's fast on this level. Well, until the enemy starts spawning. I say for some reason, I know exactly what the reason is. It's because there's not that much on this level. Until the enemies show up. Alright, so we have to... Crap. I didn't mean to jump there. We have to wait for these mushrooms to spawn. Grab... Oh, hey, I got it. I thought I missed it. Yeah. No. Lava and water, equally dangerous. Now, if I didn't have an infinite supply of axes, then I'd have to go around collecting these axes to kill these things. Alright, so that's mushroom 1 of 2. Gotta collect one more. I hit you with an axe. Alright. Alright, this level went by, it went pretty smoothly. This can get pretty frustrating if the mushrooms won't show up, as they often don't. Alright, go Conan. Or whoever you are. Alright, let's get this dragon out of the way before it multiplies. I guess they're just gonna pop up out of nowhere. Alright, well in that case, let's ignore the dragons for now. Go down and get one of these mushrooms. Or, you know, jump in the lava. Either way works. Oh, and you also can't throw your axe in the air. So. Oh, hey. Wasn't expecting that to actually work. Alright, there's like a billion things flickering on the screen now, so the controls are abysmal. However, once a certain number of dragons spawn, they won't show up anymore. Oh, hey! Haha! My axe hit it on the return. Wait. What happened to the mushrooms? What do I do? That sound you hear is the lightning barrier up there crackling. And it keeps making that sound until you disable it. Actually, don't know what to do. I've never had all the mushrooms disappear on me before. That's weird. Maybe I have a mushroom and it's just not showing up in my inventory? No. Huh. Can I go back to the Oh, okay. Weird. Alright, let's go down and get that mushroom then. Because I want to stop that noise as soon as possible. It's like kryptonite for the eardrums. Or whatever part of the ear is the part that lets you hear horrible noises like that. Oh, thank God. Just relish the silence for a few moments. Alright, this level's pretty straightforward. You just have to wait for these eyeballs to show up, kill them, and for every eyeball you kill, a section of this ladder mysteriously appears. I'm not sure what that device is, but it shoots bolts and creates these little sparkly creatures. Oh my god, it's so painfully slow. This computer is not meant to handle this much stuff going on the screen at once. Now see, I said this level straightforward, but if you miss the eyeball and you have to go chasing it around, then it becomes much less straightforward. Much easier to just die when that happens, because it clears all the enemies off the screen and it causes a new eyeball to spawn. So if you have infinite lives, then that's the strategy I'd recommend. Yeah, I knew that would happen. Yeah, destroy whatever that thing is. And now I can go through the snakehead door. Now this level's fun, because if you fall through that hole in the bottom of the level, then you have to do the previous level all over again. Alright, so I need to kill three of these green sparks. Every time I kill one, it drops a mushroom. And I need to put the three mushrooms in these three devices. Now, if it's a red spark, I don't think I can kill it. Or maybe I can kill it, and it just doesn't drop anything. Oh. So I can, like, deflect it. I don't know what you're supposed to do on this level if you have a bunch of these sparks, because eventually you'll run out of axes. And eventually you'll get hit and die. And eventually run out of lives, which of course I don't have to worry about because of filthy computer hackers. Not sure when that dragonfly down there will become an issue. I know it becomes an issue at some point. Damn it, another red spark? Good thing I have infinite axes. Okay, here we go. Just gotta make sure these things don't kill me before I can get the mushroom. Yeah! Alright, I died, but I got the mushroom, so it's okay. Oh, okay. Now the dragonfly is released. I'm not sure why. Maybe it was triggered because I picked up a second mushroom? Not sure. And remember, at any time, I can fall down that hole, go back to level 6, and lose all of this progress. No saving, of course. Which, you know, I mean, it's not that hard to jump over that pit. Oh, here we go. And my bird friend destroyed my enemy and carried me to freedom. Thus Volta was destroyed, and Conan continued in search of high adventure. Apparently, I guess Volta is a character from the Conan universe. Alright. Anything else? I got 3 bonus, or 60,000 bonus points for beating the game with 3 lives. Oh, and you just start over. Alright, so, notice how every time I throw an axe, my axe counter effectively goes up by 1, Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to use this to break the game. When you press the scroll lock key, it switches into full speed mode, which is how this game would be running, you know, at my actual processor speed. So I'm going to throw a bunch of axes, and hopefully once I hit 255, something pretty exciting will happen. And once you go over 100, you get the Super Mario Brothers effect when you go over 99 lives, where it just kind of throws some random garbage in there. And should be getting pretty close. Oh, there we go. Cracking Elite Software, Paris, 1985. Alright. And that was Conan. Man, I feel kind of naked talking with no music like this. Just my bare voice. Maybe I should play some Commodore music or something. Okay, let's see, what else do we have here? Alright, this is one of my favorite Apple games. This is a game that was also on the Commodore 64. Let's see. And I think it was on some other home computers of the time. But, this is a pirate software. Oh, wait, I'm still in super speed mode. Okay. Most of the discs I had were like this. It's just a bunch of commercial games slapped onto one disc with a bootleg menu screen on it. But I'm going to play some Drelbs. And like with Conan, this is a cracked version of the game that has built-in cheats. So I'm going to say yes, I want lots of men. This is the crack screen. Make sure you call these numbers as well for some great information from the sound barrier and future world. Those are BBS numbers, of course. Oh, you play Dig Dug in the arcade? That's cool. I never had Dig Dug. But I understand it is a popular game. Alright. It's a pretty cool intro sequence. Oh, no. I don't want the attract mode. Oh, wait. Is this the... Okay. So I guess it just defaults to beginner if you don't actually select an option. Alright, so the goal of this game is to create squares. For some reason. And these things are chasing you around. You want to get this heart when it pops up. But kind of difficult because as soon as you approach it, it teleports. And... So when you get the heart, it freezes the enemy, so you can trap them in a square. Crap. Except I screwed it up. If you trap them in the square, then they're incapacitated for a while. You can also trap them when they're not frozen, but obviously it's a lot more difficult because they're moving around and... Oh! When you see a human face pop up, you want to walk into it for massive points. So someone did make like a flash, version of this game, but I wouldn't recommend it. It's pretty poorly done. I think it was Flash. It might have even been Java. Oh crap! You want to get that diamond when it pops up because that immediately makes the exit pop up. Right. So this is the second phase of Drelbs. When you walk into these things, they just kind of fire off in a random direction. There's no real way to shoot them at that enemy, but I don't think it does anything if you do. Excellent. I know, it's awesome, Sarah. Like, I hate when they try to do music on the Apple, but I love the sound effects. very, very crunchy and satisfying sound effects. So now we have two of those orange critters running around instead of just one, and two of the diamonds. Dang it. Ah. Oh no! Wait. I'm supposed to have lots of men. Oh. Wait, it started me over. That's weird. I guess the cheat didn't work. Let's do one more without the cheat, I guess. I guess I could try Dig Dug, as long as I'm here, even though I never played it. I was mostly going to show off games I'm familiar with in this stream, and then later on, maybe play some games I'm not familiar with. No. I'm not one of those disgusting cheaters. Alright, so I just hit one immediately, so hopefully the game will work as intended now. I'm not sure why it kicked me to a game over. Aw, man. I got fixated on the heart. You gotta watch out for that. Gotcha. Unfortunately, they don't stay frozen for very long, but it's very satisfying when you manage to do it. Ah. Oh, he was still frozen because I picked up that second green heart, but the effect was wearing off. Sometimes you get in a position where you just can't make any more squares, and these blue faces will start popping up, and they will kind of reconfigure the lines. So you can make more squares. You have to either go into that weird field of sprites that look like you, or no, you have to either get the diamond, which causes that field to pop up, or you have to make enough squares to make the exit pop up. I know, very confusing terminology in this game. I apologize. Up. Welcome, Cistern or Cistern. Thanks for coming, even if you don't know why you're here. Hope you stick around. Alright, where's it gonna be? Ah! Damn it! Ugh! Yes! Alright, hopefully I can make it a little further this time, because if I die, I won't immediately game over. Hopefully. Maybe the game is just glitched. For some reason, this music really reminds me of Metroid. I mean, I use the term music under advisement, but if you can call this music, it sounds kind of like Metroid music. The Apple II didn't actually have sound hardware, like all of the sound effects of music in Apple games. It's just like making a click at an extremely high frequency. So they're kind of fudging it. Oh, was that the original Metroid? Yeah. That is a tough game. Oh crap, the bullets are like bouncing around like mad. See, this is a great game for the Apple specifically, because it doesn't try to do too much on the screen, so you don't have to deal with as much slowdown. Oh! No way I can get that one, but at least I got one of them. Oh, diamond. Yes! Aw, man, that sucks, Sore Thumb. It never fails. Every time I stream on Twitch, it works for some people and it doesn't work for other people. And I don't know why. I mean, maybe in your case, it's just the app. I don't know. There's two of these guys now. What? Damn it! So yeah, if you die on that screen, it kicks you back to this one. Oh god. Stay away from me. No way I can freeze this guy. Or capture that guy. Oh well. Oh god. Oh man, there were too many enemies around. Hey, what's up, Private Steve? Farting noises? That's not fair. Well. Okay, maybe they're like electronic farting noises. Oh god. Why did I go back? I don't know. Let's see, any other squares I can make? Let's see. Oh wait, yeah, there's one in the middle there. Or did that just appear? I don't know. You can tell that it's going to turn into an exit because of that little sound effect it just made. Or one of them's going to turn into an exit. Oh man, I walked into him. I'm a dummy, but thought I could make it past him. Where's it going to be? Oh man, it could be over here now. It's crazy. Phew. Thought I was going to die. It's one hell of an ending screen. And it just starts over from the beginning. Alright, well, let's play Dig Dug as long as I'm here. I could play Robotron, but it doesn't play very well with the joystick, and I don't really want to deal with the keyboard controls. Let's play some Dig Dug. J to use the joystick. I think I will. Man, that music is rough. This does not... Oh my god. Is that supposed to be music? Or is that sound effects? No, that's gotta be music. Wow. Oh my god, this is rough. Alright, so I have to pump this guy up, right? I know that much. Alright, so I can't dig... Well, I can't dig through that stuff. Do I collect... Oh, man. I can't deal with that music. I'm sorry. Oh, I know. The arcade is better. And, I mean, that game got ported everywhere. It got ported to, like, the Nintendo and all sorts of other far superior consoles. You see, that's why Drelbs is good. It doesn't try to do more than the Apple is capable of. I mean, the Apple can't do music like that, so I don't know why they tried. I think it's sound effects because they stop when you stop moving. Well, I mean, you'd think so, but I think the processor just can't handle moving sprites and creating music at the same time. Alright, oops. I'm supposed to go to this screen when I change the discs to be more professional. If you're paying attention, you got a sneak preview of what's to come. Alright, well, let's look at a classic arcade game that's much better done on the Apple. Let's see, where is it? Ah, here we go. Let's play some Mario Brothers. I have to press a number to actually run the disk or run the program. Type letter to... Oh wait, I know what the problem is. A lot of times the Apple II will just expect you to have the caps lock key on, and if you don't, then it'll cause problems. Wait, it's still not working. Type letter to run or load, lock, unlock, delete, rename. Am I not clicked? Oh. I bet I have to click back on the thing. brought to Canada by Mr. Silicon. Cracked by Kilroy Was Here. I don't think that's his real name, guys. Reminds me of playing Elder Scrolls Arena on DOSBox. Yeah, Elder Scrolls Arena is a... that's a hell of a game. Alright, so I want... okay, Mario's on joystick. That's how I want. You can't play with two joysticks, so whoever's not using the joystick is using the keyboard. One or two player. Stick with just one. I can modify the keys, but I don't need to. Let's see, what are my options? Oh, I guess the option screen is just this. I just press that during the game to get back to the screen. Alright. Phase 1. You can select what level you started on, which is kind of interesting. Not sure how many phases there are. And space to start. Yeah, there's some music there, but it doesn't have music continually playing. It's just not a good idea. So yes, if you've ever played Super Mario Bros. 3 on the NES multiplayer, then you should be familiar with this. Or if you played any of the billion versions of this that they released with other Mario games. Got some nice crunchy sound effects. And it's really weird to be playing an officially licensed Mario game on an Apple computer. Something that would never happen in this day and age. But it was a crazier time. I think this was officially licensed. It had to have been, because otherwise they wouldn't have needed to crack it. Alright, let's try not to kill myself here. Hit this pal. You know, a pal, like in Mario Brothers. And that's some good sound effects. Also, I like how the coins are worth dollars in this. Very, very accurate. Hell yeah, I'm perfect. The Mario in this looks like a terrible Mario ripoff. Yeah. Kind of everything on the Apple looks like a terrible Mario ripoff. Or it looks like a terrible ripoff of something. So no flies in this version. Just go straight to the crabs. I'm not sure if the arcade version had flies or if that was just the NES version. Gotta hit him twice. If you get a combo like that, then the second one is worth more points. If you hit them both off the screen at roughly the same time. And we all know how important points are. Uh-oh, it's the last ones was really fast. Damn it. I died. Man, stupid fireball. Why'd you have to ruin my day? No! Damn it! I wasn't close enough to kick it. Oh, there's the flies. They show up after the crabs for some reason. At least I guess these are supposed to be flies. You kind of have to use your imagination with the Apple II, even more so than the NES. Much smaller pixel density. Can I kill the fireballs by hitting them from below in this version? I forget. I know you can do that in the Mario 3 version. Eh, not going to give me a chance to try. Oh my god, this thing is so slow. I thought there was another one, but I guess this is the last one. Oh, come on. Ultra combo! Looks maybe 8-bit to me. Well, I think technically the NES and the Apple II were both 8-bit computers, or they both had 8-bit processors, but the NES was much... I mean, the NES was built for games, and the Apple II wasn't. Or it wasn't built for games the same way the NES was. You know, their primary focus was, you know, the all-purpose personal computer. You know, do your word processing. File your taxes. You know, keep a database of your recipes, that kind of stuff. You know, this was pre-internet, so it was a lot harder to convince your parents to buy you a computer in those days. Especially since they were so expensive. You know, even for the time, like even taking inflation into account, or even if you didn't take inflation into account, they were still monstrously expensive at the time. Oops, wasted a PAL. Damn it. I'm sliding on the ice. Ice level is the bane of every Mario player ever. I think it's much closer to 6-bit. I don't think 6-bit processors are a thing. And we're back to turtles again. But there's gonna be a bunch more fireballs and crap on the screen now. Alright, so that's Mario Brothers. While we're here, just take a real quick look. See, it's another disc with Robotron on it, so you kind of had multiple copies of games spread out across various pirate discs. I think the Apple version of Pac-Man was actually pretty good. Check out that logo. High fidelity. Wait, those names seem off to me. Not really sure how. How many players? 5. Yes, you can play Pac-Man 5 player on the Apple II, but we'll just play 1. Alright, that's a pretty good version of the Pac-Man music. Here we go. This is the stuff. I mean, obviously it's not going to be arcade perfect or anything, but it still beats the hell out of the Atari 2600 version. And they managed, you know, not to have too much slowdown. Oh, is the music still too loud? Yeah, I was worried that would be the case. Let me deal with that in a sec. Uh-oh, I'm dead. Nope. All right. Okay, you all know what Pac-Man looks like. Let's find something else. Let's see. All right, here's a really interesting one. As far as I know, this only came out on the Apple. I don't know if it came out on anything else. It might have come out on the Commodore and stuff. This is Arcade Boot Camp. Check out this intro. Wait. Why can I read what the arcade is thinking? It's a good superpower. The ability to read the minds of arcades. Alright, I'm gonna play some Crop Duster. Wow, the bomb didn't even blow up the cow. Oh wait. I think I was supposed to blow up the cow. Okay, I guess everyone communicates telepathically. This was one of my favorite games on the Apple as a kid. It's just so weird. Gasp! So wait, you're controlling the cows trying to get hit by the bomb? Oh no, I guess you're controlling the plane. You don't actually get to play Crop Duster. That's just the example game. Alright, and it just starts the intro over again. Oh, I clicked off the window, apparently. Alright. Oh, hey, look. I already have a save file on this one. Enter ID number, Duke. Press escape key to earn higher rank. Not sure what the E5 is. I guess that's the number of points I have. Alright, so the premise of this game is you're trying to become a better arcade game player. And there are 5 training courses to participate in. To hone your arcade skills. I don't know if the Apple II is the best thing to play to hone your arcade skills. But, hey, look, it actually shows you what the buttons do. Kind of interesting. Something you don't see very often in Apple games. So I'm not sure if you're actually scored on time here. I think you're just scored on accuracy, in which case I already screwed up. ...77% hit rate. Gotta work on that. Oh god. I'm not doing very well. I did much better when I was messing around with Apple discs earlier. Oh, come on. Oh yeah, the clown games in Rogue Legacy. Yeah, that is kind of similar. Moving targets. All right, let's blow up some tanks. That's what you do in boot camp, right? Blow up some moving tanks, and then try to hit birds. blow some poor innocent birds out of the sky? Like you're that one baseball pitcher who hit a bird in midair with a baseball? Okay, so I didn't do too well on that one. But, see what else this game has. I like this game a lot as a kid, just because of how much variety it has. You know, I spent a lot of time, you know, getting good at all of these games. Because, you know, when you're a kid, you have all the free time in the world. Don't know why you can duck in this game. It doesn't actually do anything. Makes me feel safer. I think you have to survive for 10 units of time. It's not exactly 10 seconds, but it's not quite 10 minutes. Hey, nice going. The game complimented me. Love that jump animation. You just stick both legs out as far as... Ah! Yeah. Stick both legs out in the air as far as they'll go. Doesn't really change the patterns up. It's kind of, it's the bouncing one, the single boulder, and the double boulder every time. It gets kind of boring. Elevator action. I don't know what the zip button does. It doesn't seem to do anything. So it says there's... Shut up. It says there's a jump button and a zip button, which I assume would be like a run button, but doesn't appear to make you run. Oh, come on! I don't know why that didn't work. It's exactly the thing I did last time when I died. You think it would work this time? And I did not hit the jump button. I hit the other button. Alright, well, let's skip straight to the big finish here. The grand finale. Oh wait, that's right. Okay, this isn't the grand finale, but this is a pretty interesting game in its own right. You just gotta drive and don't hit shit. I like how the steering wheel turns in your car. That's a nice touch. It's the little details that make a game memorable. Some really nice animation. For the Apple, yeah. You usually don't see stuff like this on the Apple, which is why I really liked Arcade Bootcamp. It just has a bunch of stuff you don't usually see. Oh, this is exciting. All right. Now the icy road. Uh-oh. So you gotta be extra careful because it's black ice. The worst kind. Man, check out that engine noise. That's some playing card in the spokes of your bicycle wheels. Kind of sound effect going on. Realistic engine action. Oh, come on. Alright, this one's dumb. Can I just quit? I just want to quit. No, I have to do it. Okay. Wait. Oh. I sucked too bad, so now I'm on potato peeling duty. I forgot about that. And it's its own special minigame. I love that. Evade Spud. The only video game in existence that instructs you to evade the Spud. Oh, come on! This is kind of humiliating. Why do I need a separate knife for every potato? What happens if I try to peel another one? Oh, I sucked at potato peeling. Check out my Spud data. It is not good to cook unpeeled spuds or to grab a spud without having the knife. Remember the mine zones. Alright, so is this the one I'm thinking of? There's one that's like, use every skill you learned in the game. Yeah, here we go, survival training. Bugles and flags are very military. Alright. So we start off shooting some pop-up targets here. Should be familiar. Ah, crap. I think if you miss 6 times, you lose. And we have to shoot birds while dodging cannon fire. Very hectic. Shoot these missiles down, or bombs down, before they kill us. Maybe you can only miss 5 times. Crap. It's hard to tell what part of your head the shot's going to come out of. I mean, you'd think it would be the exact middle. But it's a little bit to the right or the left, depending on which way you're facing. Alright, so now I have to dodge these boulders and get to the flag. So, it gave me a hint about bugles. So, I died because I touched the bugle? Really? Careful thinking is the key to this challenge. No information can be given out. Alright. So that's Arcade Boot Camp. It's a fun little game. I like it. Let's see. Oh, here we go. It's time to play a classic. Choplifter. This is another one of those games that came out on pretty much every home computer at the time, and the Apple version is actually pretty good. First, sortie. I assume that sortie means helicopter, but I have no way of knowing. Alright, so there's actually a little bit of a 3D plane going on here. Well, sort of. You have to. Your verticality determines where your shots land. So, one button turns you around, and the other button shoots. You can shoot left or right. Usually, you're going to be shooting down, at least in the first few levels. Alright, blow up these tanks, rescue these people. You have to be careful, because if you land on the person, then you will kill them. And that dude just got shot by a tank. Sucks to be him. I like the little wave they do. Aw, man. Sorry. I like this game because you're just trying to rescue people. And the only reason you have to be violent is because you have to, you know, it's totally self-defense. This is just a rescue mission. If you would just leave me alone, I wouldn't have to kill you. Your helicopter can hold 16 people, and then after that I have to return to the base. So, I have to wait for the tank to blow this house up before I can rescue these people. I mean, I like to fill up before I head back to the base. I forget, can I? Maybe I can shoot them myself. I forget. Oh yeah, you can. Sorry guys, I just had to blow up your house so I can rescue you. Alright, 16 is the max, right? Pretty sure. Yeah. They won't get in because the helicopter is full. Alright, so back to base. I was doing fine until you blew up my house. I didn't need rescued. I guess they're like military prisons or something. I mean, I'm not exactly sure where this is. I mean, it appears to be America because there's an American flag there. Maybe these are like... Maybe this is a dark alternate future where... Where the communists won. I don't know. It might be a story to Shoplifter. I never had the manual. These planes are extremely hard to hit. You're probably better off just avoiding them. No! Wait. Maybe you can't hit the planes. Sure looked like I hit the thing and nothing happened. Hey, stop killing my men. Alright, get in. Ooh. Man, that was close. Just barely dodged that plane's gunfire. Oops, I squashed him. Oh well. Screw you, plane. Just trying to do my job. I've lost 7 people. Which is, it's not horrible. I mean, I guess it's horrible for those 7 people, but... In terms of my score, it could be worse. Alright, back to base. I forget if this game... Oops! Oh yeah, if you die with a full helicopter, all those 16 people die. Like, I'm not sure if this game, if anything changes, or if there's an ending or anything. I never actually did that well in the game. This is about as far as I've ever made it, actually. But it's a fun old time. Alright, that's enough of that. A sortie refers to a flight. For sortie basically means first mission. Oh, okay. Interesting. Oops. You aren't supposed to see that. Alright, let's play some Boulder Dash. No, it's not Boulder Dash. Not bullshit. It's Boulder Dash. I love this game. I made it really far in this game when I was a kid, but I kind of suck at it now. Not sure what the difference between Apple joystick and Joyport. Oops. If you don't select something in enough time, it starts and it doesn't work. Yeah, I'm not sure what the difference between these two options is. Let's see. Cave A level 1. All right, sounds good. All right, so your goal is to collect enough of these diamonds to open up the exit and leave to the next level. And if the boulder falls on you, you die. Pretty straightforward. For some reason, the boulders have gravity, but nothing else in the game does. Oops. And I disobeyed rule number 1. Don't get hit by a boulder. Yeah, sometimes the rules the boulders obey, it's kind of weird. Like, if it doesn't have anything next to it, then it'll fall even if there's something below it. Like, if I get rid of this, or... Oh, I think 2 boulders have to be stacked on top of each other for that to happen. So, like, if I get rid of these, then this boulder to the left of me will fall, even though it's sitting on top of a boulder. So, yeah, kind of weird. I'm doing terribly. I gotta at least make it a couple levels in. I know what the problem is, I'm thinking too much. I just have to go with my muscle memory on this one. I played the hell out of this game. Another one of those rare Apple II games that actually has a scrolling screen. So that white flash means that the exit is open, I think, but you can collect the rest of the diamonds for bonus points. And yeah, the scrolling is really jerky and kind of nauseating. But when you're a kid, you play what you have. It's actually possible to get trapped as well. Oh, I think that means I got a one-up. That weird staticky effect, I think that means I got enough points to get an extra life. So yeah, if you get trapped, then all you can do is waste a life and restart the level. So, you gotta be careful. This is kind of like Sokoban, only, you know, more hectic. Well, I guess it's not really like Sokoban because you're not really pushing stuff around. There's a pretty similar game called, I think it's called Crystal Mine or something like that. That sort of takes the Boulder Dash concept and expands on it. Alright, exit's open, but let's clear the level out first. I think that's everything. Oh, there's an enemy trapped down there. But I'm not going to be foolish enough to unleash it. It's a prologue of Wolfenstein. Choplifter, yeah. Probably. I never played Wolfenstein, the original version, which was on the Apple II. I did play Smurfenstein, though. Which is a parody of Wolfenstein. And I'm going to take a look at that. It's really dumb. Oh god. No! I got smashed. Alright, there's one man left. So yeah, this is another... Oh god. This is another one of those games that the Apple version is definitely not the best version of it. But, I'm still fond of it because that's the version I played. I realize it's just nostalgia goggles, but it still has a special place in my heart. Damn it, this game gets really hard too. Game over. Oh, yeah, I made the high score list. D-O-B. That stands for Duke of Bump. I guess I could have put D-U-K, but people might think it says duck. Alright, so that was Boulder Dash. So I never played any of the RPGs that came out on the Apple. Like, I never played Wizardry or Ultima or anything like that. Which, you know, I would have. I didn't have those. But I'd definitely take a look at those if I was familiar with them. Let's see. All right. Well, let's go ahead and take a look at Smurfenstein since I mentioned it. This is really dumb. Right. Prepare your eardrums. Yeah. This is Castle Smurfenstein, made by Dead Smurf Software. I don't know why I had this game and not Wolfenstein. Alright, so I need to reverse the controls, because otherwise the controls will be all weird. Jay, move your joystick towards the Yukon. Move it towards Labrador. Let's go kill. Alright, let's start a new game here. Control C. Or no, let's do Control R. Just completely randomize the level. And J for joystick. During the cold winter of... Oh. I was trying to read that. Okay, oh god. Alright, so you start with a gun. These are the Smurfs. To use your gun, you have to hold button 1. Oh wait. Oh. I moved and I got busted. Well, that's an inauspicious start. Let's try again. Oh, I know what the problem is. I have the fast load time option selected. You're supposed to read that text while it's loading information in. Or while it's loading data in. Damn it. It's another bedroom. Okay. Try to just kill these guys this time. No, no, no. Alright, let's try one more time. Let's create a new level. Hopefully this goes a little better this time so I can show off some more of the stupidity in this game. This might actually just be a mod for Wolfenstein. I don't know. Maybe they just like replaced the enemies, because I know the original Wolfenstein game was pretty similar to this. Why isn't my... Okay, there we go. So... Alright, so after I kill this guy, you can walk on his corpse and hit space to search him. 7 bullets and keys. Okay. I don't know how to actually check my inventory. It does that every time you walk into something in this game. Walk into a wall, you get that. Alright, so... Can we open this door? Yep, he opened it for me. Okay. 2 bullets and keys. Everything, let's search this crate. Everything just takes a ridiculous amount of time in this game, which, if I remember correctly, that's how it was in Wolfenstein as well. The original Wolfenstein game. So I would recommend utilizing, if you have it, your speed up ability. Blue suits. Was that like a costume? So I can dress up like a Smurf? Whoa, that's awesome. I look like them, apparently. Oops, wrong button. I never actually found that before. That's cool. I wonder how effective that is. To open a box, point your gun at it and wait for 3 minutes. Well, it's not quite 3 minutes, but let's skip it anyway. Bullets, okay. Always welcome. I'm not sure if, like, maybe if you keep trying, your keys might work. Like, I'm not sure if you're, like, trying different keys or if I'm just wasting my time by trying the same keys over and over again. Alright, I can't unlock this door, so I think I can shoot through it. Yeah, it takes a few bullets, but eventually you'll get it. Jesus Christ. Okay. I mean, that's absurd. Who thought this was good game design? And I mean, it's not because it's like a parody game or a mod or whatever, it was like this in the original game. I mean, if there were enemies or something, and I'm like, oh crap, I have to, you know, I have to be careful and, you know, wait until I kill everyone or knock everyone out before I open this crate. But I mean, if they were trying to create tension, it doesn't work. Back bacon, also known as Canadian bacon. This game has a lot of weird Canadian jokes for some reason. It tastes gross. Okay, great. I don't know if I can see my health or if I can see what I'm carrying. Eye doesn't work. It doesn't bring up your inventory. I'm afraid to start hitting other buttons because I don't want to, like, accidentally quit the game. Let's search this guy. Apparently, keys are pretty useless in this game. Call the number. I mean, I'm sure these, like, these bulletin board numbers are long, long inactive. I would be kind of curious to call the mech support number, though, and just see what I get. I might do that before the stream ends. Oops, wrong button. Yeah, it's kind of awkward because you have to use both the joystick and the keyboard. Well, you don't have to use the joystick, but it makes it easier. But since there are only two buttons on the joystick, then Molson Golden. I had no idea what that was when I was a kid. Now I know that Molson is a brand of beer. Not sure if that does anything or if it's just a dumb joke. Yeah, take that. Aw, he closed the door. That jerk. Hey, my keys actually worked for once. Oh god. Oh god. I took his stuff and then I killed him. You can play this game any way you want. No! I got hit. Alright, well, before we go for the night, let's see what happens when I call that mech support number. Just out of curiosity. Is this the right thing? Yeah, there we go. Okay. So I'm going to call up the mech distribution department in St. Paul, Minnesota. Let's see what I get. Let's turn my volume up a little bit so you can hear whatever is on the other end of this call. Okay, 612-481-3527. Probably not going to be anything. And this will be anticlimactic.
Hi, Richard Rosie. I can't come to the phone right now, but if you leave me a message, I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thanks and have a great day.
Yes, hi. I was wondering if the manual for Number Munchers was still available. Please give me a call back at 304-986-5854. Thank you. All right, so I'm not sure who that was, but hopefully they can get back to me with some more information, and if I can get a copy of the manual, then I will let you all know. And that'll about do it for the stream. So thanks everyone for watching. I still have a buttload of games that I was wanting to look at, and I just don't have time to, so hopefully I can do another one of these in the not-too-distant future. I do want to get back to Dokapon Kingdom as well. I still have a long way to go in that game, so I should be doing that soon. And as always, more Binding of Isaac is always on the table. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, everyone. And I will see you guys next time. Goodbye.